Okay, what I forgot to do in the last part here was explain something that you should be doing as well. In order to get to the super secret World 9 of the Super Mario All-Stars version of Lost Levels here, you have to beat the game without any warp zones, basically. So, I don't know if you have to beat it without, like, without continuing or something like that, or you can't, like, quit the game and then go back to it or something like that. So what I'm gonna be doing here is just doing little save states before the end of each part, just so I can kind of, like, resume that, because I would like to get to that World 9, you know, just to show you guys what it's like and stuff like that, as well as give you a walkthrough on it. I've never actually been to World 9 myself, so this will be a pretty interesting experience once I get to it, since it'll essentially be blind. Oh, and, hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Yeah, I just had to explain that right off the bat there, otherwise I would have forgotten about it throughout the course of this thing, and then you would have seen the save state and stuff like that, and yeah. I'm not going to be using save states to cheat, per se. I'm just using that to preserve my point in the game when I have to shut off the game after each part to, to process the Cam Studio video and stuff like that. So what I actually did was I restarted the game from the very beginning and went through those levels all over again. I figured it doesn't really matter since I'm early in the game and stuff like that. And yeah, so let's just continue the walkthrough as normal. And as you see, it's another fish sort of bridge. Well, I shouldn't say it's another one. It's the... Wow, what the heck? Can they hit you as they're popping out or something? They're not supposed to be able to do that. Anyway, the... fish bridge. Always stay like right in the middle and point yourself in the direction that you want to be going at all times, so the fish pop up in that direction and in turn they'll be predictable. Or at least you hope. Sometimes they aren't all that predictable. And that's the stage there. Hopefully I'll be able to get to World 9, because as I said, I've never been there before, and I would really like to play it myself. I think that would be, oh, pretty cool. I really jumped the gun there. I should have looked ahead and just let those Goombas plop themselves in the lava. But alas, I was way too hasty. Or just let that Koopa shell just do my dirty work for me. That works too. Okay, so let's carefully trounce our way down here. Uh-oh. And a long jump with a fire bar and horrible jump controls? Okay. Whoa, boy. Not liking the looks of this danger zone here. Game's already getting pretty hard for a castle level compared to the original Mario. But this is what you expect out of Lost Levels. And hello, Bowser. How's it going? Yeah! Will the princess be here? She better be in that bag. I am tired of visiting castles. Oh, it's not her! It's just two more toads. What? How many toads are there in the Mushroom Kingdom anyway? Well, I suppose it is called the Mushroom Kingdom after all, so it makes sense. But still, oh god, Hammer Brothers! No! You live! Why are you here? Why do you exist? Can I sneak up? There we go. Mushy? Mush? Please need power up me, PkGam, English, and what? That was like my worst death yet because of controls. I shouldn't blame the controls. I should say I should blame myself for not being used to the controls, and I was being way too hasty there. Whoa! Whoop, there we go. I really snuck through the hammers that time. And bloop. Okay, power up. Me want. I don't really care about the stars so much as I want a power up. Yeah, that won't hurt me at all, as long as I have the star. Yeah. Oh, there's a mush! Yes! Okay, now I feel a lot more confident in my skills, if you can call them skills. But... what? Why is that there? It's just there to make you fall through and then you can't get back up or something like that. And, whoa, that was really bad momentum, but somehow I made it. Somehow I survived. What? More invisible coin blocks. I'm just waiting for one to be right at the edge of a jump or something like that, above a bottomless pit. And I failed on the spring! And what's gonna happen is that it's just gonna plummet me to my doom, because I'm gonna hit the block and plop right into the abyss. And those blocks are not worth it. There's probably a power-up in them, but that is just not worth it whatsoever. Oh, no! Well, at least I got two more lives. Alright, well, let's take this a little more seriously. Hopefully we'll have more successful runs. Yeah, avoiding the Koopas as we go is actually... Holy cow, I have to bounce on the Koopa otherwise to get up there. Or a bullet, that works. What? You can't use a bullet to jump up there. This is blasphemy. Okay, so let's just use the Koopa to... And the piranha plant pops out. I should have known better. All that time wasted just sitting around doing nothing. And then a piranha just nips me right in the bud. Literally. Get it, bud, butt, and oh, and I'm gonna have to restart this from the beginning. Cut! Wow, didn't even need to cut there. Okay, we're back over here already. That was Quirrick. Yeah, Quirrick is an actual word. Gotta look that up in the dictionary. And I think I am, oh god, I'm scared. Is this a super springy? Yes, it is. Okay, will I get the one up this time because I'm super high in... Holy cow, this is not worth it. No, no one up, but that's okay. I don't really care so much about getting the one-ups at the top of the flight poles, in case you didn't notice that. Just saying. I could have jumped over the flagpole, I think, as well, if I had some rhythm when I hit that spring. But that was not the case because I kind of held back thanks to that hole. I was a scaredy pants, and now we're underwater. Here's the water that you can swim in. Whoa, I forgot about the bottomless pits there. I just suck you right in. So yeah, you can't fall into water when you're on, like, jumping land portions. But sure, you can swim in this water, no problem whatsoever. Never ever got that. Never ever understood that. You guys are horrendous. Go over there. Preferably off-screen where you can despawn. I don't want to get chewed up by the cheep-cheep that's going my way. And holy cow, I walked myself right off the edge. That was a little bit too close there. But this the forward momentum of me is just... it's not working for me today in the slightest. So I'm gonna go underneath the fish swarm there. Or I should say school of fish. I'm not liking the looks of his positioning. Okay. Come back this way, or... Why are you going that way? Oh, okay. He's got to get out of my way in order for me to progress forward, basically. That's my plan. And go one more square over. Thank you. And I'll just shimmy myself across here. And avoid the fish. There we go. Yeah, I know they're cheap cheeps. But you got to find other, like, synonyms for them. Otherwise, you're just calling them cheap cheeps all the time. And it gets kind of boring. And there goes the level. Woohoo! Yay! I took a long time on that swimming level. There's a lot more obstacles than there was in the original Mario Brothers. But hey, this is Lost Levels. You kind of expect that. Oh, we got some paratroopas floating along in the sky. Well, they're flying, but still. is that going to bounce back? I hope it doesn't bounce back. Okay. Usually these mushroom-like platforms, whatever the heck these things are, I don't think they're mushrooms. They seem more like hills. But I don't think that they ever have... Well, they do sometimes, but most of the time they don't have stuff that bounces shells back and stuff like that. So you're usually safe when you kick a shell forward, and you don't have to be all that cautious about it. Just so saying... I'm really hoping... Oh, I'm not liking these long jumps of death. Especially if there could have been a piranha plant. And there was a piranha plant there. Wow, I got really lucky there. And forward momentum killed me. See what I mean about that? Because I couldn't adjust my jump to land back onto that block. So I ended up overshooting it completely. Yeah, I'm just going to avoid that pipe altogether this time. And there we go. A proper jump. Oh, no. No, not Koopa hopping in this condition. Okay, I'm just going to avoid you. I just seen the flagpole and I was like, screw it. No, I'm not. It's not worth it. And you know when you bounce off an enemy in Lost Levels or the original Mario, you don't really have all that much airtime. It's just like a short hop, and it's like it's over. Boy. Can I just like... Yeah, okay. I'm just a little bit frightened here. Did I take the right... Oh, it's a multiple path thing, isn't it? Is it? Oh, got four paths. Middle? Middle? I didn't hear the da-dung or ding-ding. You know, the sound of success or failure. But from the sounds of it, I failed somewhere. Maybe I'm over-talking and I don't hear the bunk because I'm talking too much. So let's listen a little closer here. Okay, ding ding. Wrong. So it's definitely the bottom first. There we go. Let's try the bottom again. Okay, it's all the way at the bottom twice in a row. Holy cow, I hate those potables. Or potaboos. I think this is the right path. Yep! Wait, wait. Nope, I had to been on the... I mean, I had to go on the top route. Oh, just despawn the fire bars there. Sorry for being quiet here, but I've got to hear the ding-ding and blue. Yeah, okay. Yeah. No. I need to go upsy. Up, up. It's probably invisible. Aha! You trickster! What? That wasn't the right route. Anyway, I have to take the lower... And that was a lovely jump with no momentum. Okay, so it's both lower routes, and then another. I already forgot the combination there. Okay, so it's low, and go under. There we go. And wait it out, because you got bad jumping momentum. So what is it, all the lower routes or something like that on this castle? Certainly seems like it. And yeah, I'm not, as I said, not very good with my memory. So it's not my forte to go through these castles and stuff like that. See? Wait, did I get a da-doon already? I didn't hear. Okay, ding. And there we go. That's two dings. Maybe three will give me the grand prize. I don't know. I certainly am hoping. Yeah. Okay. Eh. Wrong again? What? I took all three paths. What? Or at least it seems like I took all three paths and I died. Wow. Yeah. As I said, lives don't really matter all that much in this game. It just says game over. Blah. And that's like... I mean, when you restart the level from the beginning anyway, that makes lives completely worthless. It's just like, what's the point of having a life counter? Unless it's like to challenge people from like getting or avoiding a game over or something like that. What am I supposed to like go down here? And then what? What? What do you want? What do you want on me? I didn't hear any. Come on. Let's try. Now it dings. I was up here before. You've seen me go up here before. What? And now this is the correct path again. The upper. Ugh. So down, down, up, up, and here's Bowser. Wow. Okay, you back off away from those poto boo. And there we go. That was the last ding-a-ding. I almost died though doing the ding-a-ding, but that's okay because I made it. Okay, uh-oh. Uh-oh. I don't like when there's a poto boo between me and him. I can deal with his hammers. I can deal with his fireballs. But when there's a poto boo, because they're random intervals when they pop up, which is so annoying. But there we go, and... No, there we go. I accidentally pressed the load button. I wanted to save it, just in case. Well, I hope you enjoyed this part, and I'll see you in the next part when we start World 4. Toodaloo! Yeah, sure enough, there's toads.